Welcome. In this session, we are going to understand concept of intents in Android, and finally we are going to develop a phone application for the demonstration. Let's get started. Let me take you to a quick overview on a document available on SlideShare. An intent is a messaging object you can use to request an action from another app component. We can use intent to start an activity, we can start a service, and we can deliver a broadcast using intent. As far as intent lifecycle is concerned, there are two types of intent. One is known as explicit intent, in which, for example, you can start a new activity in response to a user action or start a service to download a file in the background within our own application. Implicit intent is an example wherein you can declare an action, and this action can allow or request another application to perform some specific task. So this is how we can make use of explicit and implicit intents. Let's get started. Here is the basic example of how implicit intent work. So basically, let's say we have an application 1. Within this application 1, we have an activity A. Now with this activity, we are going to start an intent using our start activity. As soon as that intent has been initiated, Android system will receive the intent, and finally Android system is going to generate another intent, and he is going to send that to application 2, activity B, or activity of another application, and then that application will execute a task for you. So let's get started. In order to do that, we like to perform some practical things here, in which we like to have an activity 1 in our app, and later we are going to make use of default phone app to perform a call. And in order to do that, let's get started with the application. So now we are going to start a new Android Studio project, and this project will be our phone application. So let's call it as My Phone App. We are going to develop this application. Let's go next. We are going to generate and test this application for Gingerbread. We'll go next. We are going to perform this application as we'll get started with an empty activity. We'll go with empty activity, and finally we are going to click finish and we'll get started with the project. Once the project has been created, now first of all we'll get started with designing of our application. So we'll go to the design view, and within this design view we are going to take in two edit text box, in which we are going to take a call, a mobile number, and we are going to create a button. As soon as we click on button, a call will be performed on that number using concept of intent with the help of phone application already available and installed in your mobile device. So in order to get started, we are going to increase the size of this application a bit, and now we like to change the text to somewhat like phone application. So we have this text view 1, which is going to display phone application here. Now we are going to take in a text view or an edit text box from the widgets here. In the text field, you can see that we have various edit text available. We are going to take an edit text which is of phone type, and we like to drop this edit text here. We like to set a hint on this edit text control. So we'll go to the hint option at the bottom, and we are going to set a hint, and we like to specify enter a number. So a number will be entered and a hint will be specified to the user. In case if you want to put the width to match parent, we can simply put that to match parent so that it can occupy complete space. Now what we can do is we can have a button control in order to perform a call. So we like to put a button control at the bottom here, and we like to change the text of this button control to call. Now we have these two controls, edit text and button, which we like to refer in our main activity.java, and we like to get started. So in order to do that, since we have these two controls, we like to refer our button control, let's call it as BT1, and we like to have our edit text control, let's call it as ET1. So we are going to refer these controls in Java. In order to do that, let's just hide this bar. And now what we like to do, we'll use Alt Enter in order to auto import button and edit text in our application. Let's refer the controls. In order to refer, we are going to make use of method findViewById, and we like to specify r.id.editText in order to refer edit text. We will typecast edit text into an edit text component, which you have already understood in the previous session, that how we can typecast we can identify a control with its ID. An integer will be returned using findViewById. A view control will be returned at the moment here. This view control will be typecasted into an edit_text control, and then it will be stored into the et1 object, which is of edit_text type. So this is how we can make use of typecasting, and we can store elements into various view controls. Now, in the same way, we have a button control. We like to typecast it into button. We like to find view control by its ID, and we like to specify the integer ID r.id.button. So integer ID has been specified, view control has been identified, it is typecasted into button control so that we can store button control into button type here. And now we like to perform event handling on this button control. In order to do that, we like to set an onClick listener on this, and we like to create a new instance of onClick listener interface, using which we are going to override our onClick method, and we are going to perform the phone call task. Once onClick method has been created, now what we can do is we can write our business logic here. In order to perform the business logic, what we have to do is we have to receive a number. Let's say we like to receive a string number, and we like to get that from edit_text1.getText, and we like to convert that into string using toString option. And now once we have got the number, we like to perform phone call using implicit intent. So in order to perform this implicit intent, first of all, I would like to take you to common intents reference, which is available on the website developer.android.com. So we'll proceed to this website developer.android.com, and on the website here we can search for common intents. These common intents are maintained on the right hand side, wherein you can proceed to phone. Once you proceed to phone, you can see that using this intent we can initiate a phone call, and we can perform two options. We can open a dialer using action dial, and we can place a phone call directly using action call. Now we need this permission, Android permission call phone, in order to perform this action call action, and these are the actions which we have to specify to the intent. This is the data URI scheme in which the action has to be specified and the intent data has to be sent to another application. Now TEL colon and the mobile number will be specified in order to send the value. So to understand this action, we like to explain you how that action can be performed. So now let's understand the basic syntax of intent. So basic syntax of intent specify that you can create a new intent using new keyword, and you can provide the constructor intent. Within this constructor you have to specify an action, and for the phone call demo we have the sample action known as action_call or action_dial. Later we can store this value into an intent object, and this intent object will be of an intent type. Once this intent has been created, you can use the method startActivity to start your intent. And once your intent has been started, you can currently stop the current activity which is running. And in case if you don't want to do that, if you want to get return to your main activity which initiated the action, you can come in the finish as well. So now what we have is, we have a following action which we have to perform, and we have to specify data to this intent action so that data is transmitted from our current activity, which is known as main activity in our current application. From this activity, we are going to send a mobile number, and this mobile number will go with the help of an intent, and it will be sent to system first. Then system will send another intent, and this number will be specified with a format TEL colon number. So let's say it will be performed to TEL colon number, and then it will be sent to phone app, and then your phone app will be performing the call. So now this is what we have to write in our Android Studio. To do that, let's get back to Android Studio and we like to get started. So here what we want, we like to create a new instance of an intent, and within this intent we like to specify an action, and this action will be our action call. So we can instantly access or search for intent.action call. We can select this action, we can press enter. Once the action has been specified, we are going to store this action into, let's call it as call intent. We are going to store that into call intent, and the type of this call intent will be an intent type. Once this has been specified, with this intent, we have to specify a data URI scheme as well, because in the reference you can see that they have already specified that this action requires a data URI scheme, and the URI scheme should have a number in this format. So in order to set this data URI scheme, we have a method known as setData, which we can set on our call intent. So we can use call intent, we can use method setData, which can set the data URI scheme for our intent. You can see that it requires an argument which is of URI type. So what we have to do is, we have to specify a URI here instead of string. But you can see that the number is received to us in string format. So what we are going to do, we are going to modify that. So let's say we are going to parse the string into a URI. So we are going to make use of this method URI.parse, and we are going to specify the string, and this string will be converted into URI type, and then URI will be sent using setData method to the phone app using call intent. So now what next we'll do, we are going to specify the parameters, and within this we are going to specify the perimeter TEL, and after this double quote we are going to concatenate the number which we have received from the edit text. So we like to specify the number. Once the number has been specified, you can use Alt Enter to auto import URI here. Once this has been done, now what we can do is, we can perform start activity, and within this activity we can specify our call intent. Hence it has been done. Now since call intent is a paid activity, because charges will be deducted if you perform a call, so we need to specify permissions here. So in order to specify permissions, we can simply use Alt Enter, and we can add permission to call phone. As soon as we do that, a permission is added to our Android manifest file, and let me just show you. Within your manifest directory, if you open androidmanifest.xml, you can see that a permission to call phone has automatically been added. So we can specify this permission manually as well, but IntelliSense gives you opportunity to write code automatically. Here we can perform one check as well. In case if the permission is not specified by the user or not allowed by the user, we can give him a toast information that he has to allow permissions. So let's say we are going to add a permission check as well. So once we specified this permission check here, you can see that using activity compat class, we are executing a method which is a static method known as check self permission, and within the current application context, this will specify for which current active context we are searching for the call phone permission. So we like to call this method get application context here. So for the current application context, we are checking that within manifest, within permission, do we have a call phone permission, and if that is equal to permission granted, then this code will be executed. So if the permission is not granted, we are going to return back, otherwise we are going to execute start activity code. So here we are going to specify toast.makeText, and here we are going to specify our get application context. Then we are like to specify a toast that please allow call permission, and later we can specify toast.lengthlong.show. So once we are done with this, a toast will be specified and permissions are added. Now what we have to do is, we have to test this application on our device. So now we are going to test our application on our device, and here we are connected our mobile device using a Visor app. You can use Visor app to display your mobile phone screen on your computer. So now what we have is, we have this device connected. We have developer options enabled, so we can go at the top, we can select for settings, and within settings we have enabled developer options, and developer options are enabled at the moment, and we are connected through USB. Debugging has also been enabled. The drivers of my mobile device are installed on my computer so that we can automatically test our application directly into device. So now what we can do is, we can simply run this application on a device, As soon as we run, ADB will identify the device connected and we can quickly click on OK in order to test application on the device. Once the application will be compiled and built, it will be tested on our device. Now once the application has been executed, you can see that the application is running on the device. And let's say I would like to perform a call to a number. Let's say I would like to specify a number somewhat like 9654825370. At the moment, we have specified a number and we like to perform a call, but we have not specified any permissions at the moment. So once we call, he's asking that please allow call permission because permissions have not been allowed at the moment. So in order to do that, we'll go to the settings, we'll go to the top, we'll click on settings. On the settings option, we can go to applications, and within the apps, we can search for our current app. Once we clicked on apps, we can search for our My Phone app. My Phone app has been available at somewhere here. So let's say we have a My Phone app which is of 10.27 MB. Once we open that, we can see that we have the permission section here. We can click on permissions and we can specifically connect that first. So once we have the option set, we have allowed permissions for phone app. Once the permissions have been allowed, we can proceed back to our application. And now once we proceed back to our application, now we can perform the call. So once we perform a call here, now you can see that a call has been initiated to a number and call has been done. So this is how you can see that a call can be quickly performed using an Android application. Thank you for watching.